In the next several sections, we're going to be using a lot of language about sets. So let's all get on the same page, and let's start by defining what a set is. A set is simply a collection of objects. Now, here's an example of a set. Now, this set is written in roster form because all of the objects or elements in this set are between a pair of these curly braces. And we can see that this set has three elements in it. So a set that we're going to use throughout this chapter is called the natural numbers. We typically denote this set with an N, or sometimes we use a fancy version of that n. And the natural numbers is the set of all of our counting numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. When a set in roster form has these three dots here, those three dots are called an ellipsis, and that indicates that these elements continue in the same manner and go on potentially forever. We could draw an ellipsis like that and then put a final element in here, and that would indicate all natural numbers from 1 to 100. But in this case, if the ellipsis is the last element, that means that this set goes on forever. So back up here, the set 1, 2, 3, we said that this was written in roster form. We could also write the set in description form. To describe this set, let's name the set A. And our description of A is given in this way. So we have roster form, description form, and we have one more way to describe a set called set builder notation. And to use set builder notation, we're going to use this little symbol right here. That little symbol means an element of. So if we're going to write the set A from above, we would write it like this. We would say A is the set of all x values. Then we put this vertical line here, which means such that. Then we describe the values in the set. Well, the values 1, 2, 3 are all elements of the natural numbers, and they're all less than or equal to 3. So the set builder notation translates pretty directly from our description of set A above. The A equals says that A is, the braces indicate that we have a set. This x says of all x values. This vertical line here says such that. This bit here says that x is an element of the natural numbers. And this last piece says that x is less than or equal to 3. Seems like kind of a complicated way to say the set of numbers 1, 2, 3. But this set builder notation is notation that'll come in handy later. Another quick example of set builder notation before moving on to other vocabulary. Here we have B is the set of all x values such that x is an element of the natural numbers and x is greater than or equal to 3 and x is less than 8. If we wanted to write this set out in roster form, it would be the set of the elements 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now I included the element 3 because of this equal sign, and I did not include the element 8 because there is no equal sign here. Now if we have two sets, those two sets are said to be equal to each other if they contain all of the same elements. For example, the set 1, 2, 3 is equal to the set 2, 3, 1. Two sets are said to be equivalent if they contain the same number of elements. For example, if you have a set S, and S has the elements Sarah, Soccer, Sunny, and Sandwich, and we have another set C, which has the elements Casey, Cat, Cool, and Cucumber. Both of these sets have four elements, so these two sets are equivalent. Along similar lines, we can say that the cardinal number of a set is the number of elements in that set. The cardinal number of a set is denoted with a little n. So using these two sets above, we can say that the cardinal number of set S equals 4, and we can say that the cardinal number of set C is also 4. Now, if a set contains either 0 elements, or the number of elements in that set is a natural number, like 4, then that set is said to be finite. If a set is not finite, we say that it's infinite. So as a really quick example of a finite set, the set 3, 5, 7 is finite, but the set 3, 5, 7, dot, 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 with the ellipsis at the end, is an infinite set, because with the ellipsis, we assume that set goes on forever. A couple more vocabulary words. A set is well defined if its elements can be clearly determined. For example, the set of the first 10 presidents of the United States is clearly determined, so it's a well-defined set. However, the set of the best 10 presidents of the United States is not well defined because the word best depends on individual opinions, so everybody's set of the 10 best presidents could be different. And a couple more important sets really quickly. The empty set is denoted in this way, or literally with some braces that are just empty, is the set that contains no elements. And last one, the universal set, which we denote with a U, contains all the elements that you're talking about in whatever particular discussion you're having. So if our sets are describing presidents, then the universal set would be the set of all US presidents. Okay, that was a lot of vocabulary. I hope it gets you started. We'll start using all of this vocabulary in the next video.